Megatron! For my brothers, I will defeat you!
By all means, try. Foolish little one, only a prime can defeat me.
I will return stronger.
I look forward to that day. Perhaps never.
Hello, Sam.
Who are you?
I am Nicomachus, the Master of Primes. I've been waiting for you.
Primes? Then can you teach me how to defeat Megatron?
Very well, but first, you will need to learn how to use the Sith of Eratosthenes.
Before we talk about the Sith, let's ask ourselves, what is a prime number? A prime number is a number larger than 1, which cannot be divided by any number other than 1 and itself. 2, 5, 7, 11, and 13 are all examples of prime numbers. And while it's rather simple to determine the primality of these relatively small integers, the questions become profoundly more difficult as the number gets higher.
So how do you find prime numbers? One way to find prime numbers is by trial division. This is done by dividing the number in questions with all the prime numbers lower than it. To show by an example, we first have the number 2, which is vacuously proven to be a prime number. We then move on to the next number, 3, and divide it by all the prime numbers leading up to 3. Since 3 is not divisible by 2, then it is a prime number. Moving on to 4, we see that 4 is divisible by 2. Therefore, it is not a prime number.
At the number 5, we have to check its divisibility with two prime numbers, 2 and 3. Since it is not divisible by 2 or 3, it is a prime number. With this method, we will be able to compile a list of prime numbers.
This method seems simple enough. However, as the list of prime numbers get larger, the test for primacy will get more tedious. Try testing for the primacy of 7465827 by testing for the divisibility of all the prime numbers less than it. That's pretty difficult.
A simpler method is to sieve out non-prime numbers from the list of natural numbers. One popular sieve is the sieve of Eratosthenes.
Eratosthenes was an influential Greek thinker, a philosopher, astronomer, mathematician and poet. He produced many important works which built on the work of his most notable Greek predecessors, such as Aristotle and Euclid.
He was the chief librarian of the Great Library of Alexandria. Some of his greatest achievements include measuring the circumference of the Earth with great accuracy and the tilt of the Earth's axis. Pretty impressive for a librarian, huh?
Although exceptional in a wide range of fields, he was never considered to be the best in any one. This earned him the nickname Beta, because he was thought to be second best at everything.
In his later years, after going blind, Eratosthenes felt his vitality was gone. He starved himself for almost 100 days that led to his death.
Many of his works have been lost to history, destroyed along with the Great Library of Alexandria. Most of what remains is in the form of references to his works.
Eratosthenes' greatest contribution to mathematics is probably his works with prime numbers. Although most of his original works have not survived, we know of what is called the Sieve of Eratosthenes through a book written by Nicomachus. While many others came up with methods of finding prime, the Sieve remains the simplest.
The Sieve is a simple algorithm which works to identify all of the prime numbers up to a certain natural number. So, how does the Sieve of Eratosthenes work?
First, we will need to modify our definition of prime numbers. We originally defined prime numbers using the concept of divisibility. We now change the definition, the concept of factorization. A number is a prime number if it only has 1 and itself as its factors. Let's say we want to find all prime numbers between 1 to 54. First, we draw a grid and fill them with numbers from 2 to 54. Then, beginning with the number 2, we cross out every multiple of that number, 4, 6, 8, 10, all the way up to 54. All of these numbers have a factor of 2. Therefore, they cannot be prime numbers. We then move on to the next lowest number, which is not yet crossed off, which is 3. We then repeat our method of crossing out every multiples of 3 in the table, 6, 9, 12, 54. If we were to repeat the steps for the rest of the numbers on the table, we would arrive at a table like this. All the numbers that are not already crossed out are prime numbers. While this algorithm is simple, it can be further improved. Let us take a look at our algorithm again. We realize that we would have found all the prime numbers after crossing out all the multiples of 7. This is because when we were to cross out the multiples of 11, the next smallest number to be crossed out would be 11 squared, which is 121. In fact, for any number n, we can stop crossing out numbers when our current number in question is greater than the square root of n. An application of the sieve of Eratosthenes is the real factorization. In real factorization, we start with the first few prime numbers, for example, 2, 3, and 5. Multiplying these primes together gives you 30. We then arrange the numbers from 1 to 30 in sequence to form an inner circle. Subsequently, write down the next 30 numbers to form the second circle, and so on. From this diagram, we first strike off the number 1, then we strike off all the spokes containing prime numbers initially used, without striking off the prime numbers themselves. Next, we strike out the spokes of all multiples of the prime numbers initially used. The numbers left that are not crossed out are mostly prime numbers. Then, the sieve of Eratosthenes is used to obtain prime numbers from these numbers.
So using such an algorithm, we are able to find out all prime numbers up to a predetermined number. But you can't take our word for it. Let us show you the proof.
Proof is omitted.
A number is either a prime or a composite number. The set of composite number is defined as the union of the set of multiples of 2 with the set of multiples of 3, with the set of multiples of 5, multiples of 7, and so on. Using the inclusion-exclusion principle, we will be able to determine the number of composites within the set of natural numbers.
Therefore, it can be said that if we were to exclude the set of composite numbers from the set of natural numbers, we will obtain the set of prime numbers.
In the sieve of Eratosthenes, by crossing out the multiples of 2, 3, 5, and 7, and so on, we are effectively removing all composite numbers from a set of natural numbers excluding 0 and 1. Therefore, what we are left with would be effectively the set of prime numbers.
Do you know, the sieve can also be used to illustrate the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, which states that any integer greater than 1 can be written as a unique product of prime numbers. Let us revisit the sieve to show how it illustrates this concept. Instead of shading, we use subscripts to represent the factors of each number. Let's take 12 as an example. 12 has 4 factors, 2, 3, 4, and 6. Taking the smallest and largest factor, namely 2 and 6, and recursively checking the largest factor until it becomes prime. In the case of 12, it can be broken down to 2 times 6, then 2 times 2 times 3. And since 3 is prime, we conclude that 12 is the unique product of 2 squared and 3. Similarly, by repeating this algorithm, we can derive the unique factors of each integer.
After hearing so much about the history of the sieve of Eratosthenes, you may be wondering, what's so good about the sieve? The sieve is relatively simple, as it does not involve any advanced mathematical concepts to apply it. As such, it is mainly used to to teach children what are prime numbers and beginner programmers how to generate primes. In addition, it is also used in programming competitions because it is easy to code and fast in generating results. Many modern sieves such as the sieve of Actines are in fact optimized versions of the sieve of Aristophanes.
Earlier, we claimed that the sieve is much faster than trial division. To illustrate how much faster it is, let us run the algorithms side by side with two MacBooks for the same range. This ensures the test is fair. In this test, the upper limit of the range is about 1, 2, 3, 1. As you can see, the sieve found all prime numbers even before trial division hit the halfway mark. From this, we conclude that the sieve is much faster than trial division.
We know that the sieve of Aristophanes can be used to find prime numbers. So after all the fuss about finding primes, you may be wondering, what can prime numbers be used for?
We know that it is relatively easy to multiply two prime numbers together to obtain a semi-prime. It is rather difficult to factorize a semi-prime into its constituent prime number. This special property makes primes useful in public key cryptography.
An example of public key cryptography is RSA. In RSA, we have a public key to encrypt a message and a private key to decrypt a message. Since these keys are derived from the product of two very large prime numbers, it is difficult to use the public key to derive the private key. Without the private key, decryption with today's computers is nearly impossible.
On the other hand, given the constituent prime numbers, we will be able to construct the private key and decrypt the message.
However, while it is one of the most efficient methods to find prime numbers up to 10 million, for prime numbers greater than that, other methods such as the sieve of Atkins are generally much more efficient. This is because as the number gets larger, the gap between prime numbers widens. More time is spent crossing out terms than actually finding the prime numbers.
I am Optimus Prime!
I've come to seek your help against Megatron!
Why should I?
He must be stopped. In his trail lies only death and destruction. Help me, Optimus Prime. You're my only hope.
Have you come to join me? Megatron, do you realize what have you done? You have to stop now and repair.
If you're not with me, then you are my enemy!
Only a Decepticon deals with Absolute. I will do what I must.
You will try!
Sorry, my brother.